When the first episode of Jujutsu Kaisen aired, it has a very generic shonen-like script. But as the series goes on, we saw how unique and different it is from its other shonen counterparts. And after 20 episodes of most consistent and movie-like animation I have ever seen in an anime, I have no doubt that this is one of the most consistent, most fluid anime I have ever seen. And all this compliments goes to the studio Nappa, because they worked on every episode just like making a short movie. You can see that every episode is better than its last one, not only story-wise but even the animations are way better. Which leads us to the episode 20 of Jujutsu Kaisen. Half of the episode 20 were totally devoted towards the fight of Toto and Yuji versus the cursed Hanami. And we saw in this fight both the sides were growing equally and at equal pace. Not at a time we saw that one is over another, as both the opponents were actually using their mind and how to overpower one over another. And on the other side we also saw Yuji using 5 to 6 black fists one after another. But not only that, this episode also had the flex king of the anime, our boy Gojo Satori, who actually came between the episode, destroyed the shield around the whole place and defeated all the enemies in the ground. But before jumping into the hype of the episode, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel, as we are going to hit 10 subscribers by the end of this video, and comment down your favorite part of this episode down in the comment section. So the episode starts and we see that Toto is having a flashback of his childhood, and we see that he's like actually beating shit out of his senior. Like that was like crazy, like he was having same personality as his like adult or youthhood, and we saw that he was pretty bold. But only then he like met a woman who was like, oh, what is your favorite type of woman? So it seemed like he got like same sort of, seems like that he got this similar personality from her, and I guess we will get to know a lot about her in like future and what who she is. But after that, right before the battle started, we saw that our boy Toto was like actually ready and was like getting prepared mentally, and he was like going to unleash his full power and telling like Yuji, like, I am going to unleash my full power. And he like gets into like a zone type of mode where he thinks like what his like next move should be, and like, it was pretty hilarious when he was like, oh, now I will use my brain power. My brain has the, like, what was his IQ number? 530,000 IQ. Like, that was absurd. And, like, he was saying that, like, just a few seconds after that, he got into the Hanami's trap, and, like, he was, like, thrown towards, like, big horns of wood. And, like, just, like, as he was, like, going to get punctured, his body was going to get punctured by the horns, he did a clap, and he shifted position with Hanami. Like, this ability is so killer, like, you can actually, like reverse the whole battle by like actually transporting yourself from a different position with a different person. Like later on in the chapter we also saw that his like this whole ability works on whosoever has this curse energy, so any being around him who has curse energy can be replaced by him. Like he can like save anyone's life, or like he can actually harm his opponent with their own technique. So this is pretty cool that both Toto and Yuji had a plan, and it seemed like so similar, like it seemed like so different from every other thing. Like they did not even tell us what the plan was, and we know what the plan actually was because the animation and the way this fight was made, like they do not need to even tell like what their plan actually is. So we see that both of them left and right like shooting blows on Hanami, and like Hanami was like actually thinking like how to get out of this. Like Toto on his side like was using like so much of different sort of pattern, like sometimes he was clapping, sometimes he was not, like he was actually twisting mind of Hanami. But as the fight goes on, Hanami also like gets like how like he's clapping and when he's not clapping, like she was also learning while fighting. But not only that, we saw like Yuji actually like using black fist one after another 5 times, and like Hanami later we also see that Nanami told that even he used black fist like only 4 times in a row consecutively. Like after this, like you knew that Yuji is going to break this score, but yeah, it was telling like how tough tough it is, because he's a professional sorcerer and Yuji is like still a kid, like going to jujutsu high and all the stuff. But this sequence, like this pattern, this type of like actually action, like they were like even like conversation with each other without any words, like just like seeing each other and getting improvement. Like even Todo, we see that he was like so excited when Yuji uses 5 black fists like one after another. He was very excited. He was having same enjoyment and expression when like her sensei, like whosoever she was, he was having like first time he saw her. So yeah, it was telling her that Todo, Yuji and even Hanami were like actually enjoying this fight, and so was I while watching this episode. That's what I think that this episode, this anime is so great about, that even the viewers are so excited to see what next will happen. They like reached to the river. What he did, like when the weapon was in his range, he like used his clap magic, not magic but curse again, and he like actually swapped Yuji with that weapon, and that was pretty cool. And after that he used like all his curse energy and even the curse energy of the cursed weapon, but Hanami did not even like get a scratch. Like she got like hurt, but like it was not that much. And then we see that Hanami finally used her like went full power. What she did, like took out the life energy of the nature and her arm absorbed it. So it seemed like her arm is a different sort of curse which it is having, because her arm actually absorbs the life energy of the plants and then makes like a curse energy out of it. But Hanami can never get this cursed energy. So Hanami was like thinking of releasing it, but she knew that he can teleport easily. So after that, what she did was she was just trying to create a domain expansion. But like just as the moment she was going to like say domain, and then we see our boy Gojo Satoru came, like he broke whole that shield around the whole area, and he was like without his that Gojo Satoru is like the king of flexing in anime. Like I am declaring him king of flexing in anime. Todo and Yuji are like getting strong, especially Yuji like with Todo has gone crazy strong. So yeah, he was like, yeah, it was right move to like pair them both. So he was like, yeah, they can like actually defeat her. And he went to the old man, old Rocky man, who was having a guitar, and like the guy who was like so obsessed of making a rack out of, like he got one shotted, not even one shot. Like Gojo just blinked his eyes and all his like two arms and two legs were like actually gone. And like old man was like, don't kill him, we need information. And like now you know why everyone is so scared of Gojo. So man, Gojo is like so cool. After that, Gojo is like, oh, now that I have defeated him, the other guy has like gone from this area, now the only guy is left is Hanami. Like how can I defeat him? He was using his whole like full on like the long range attack, when like it seems like he was like making a planet red and a planet blue and like merging them and making a purple out of it, like all the meteors, and he like just shooted it out, and like the whole like forest was like divided in half, and it seemed like Hanami was like just gone. Like she was not exhausted now, because nothing is left now. So like boy Gojo is like actually like the top tier flexing in anime. Like even if you think like what can surpass him is like nothing can surpass him, because like everyone, like even when they like made Vile, it was like just Gojo is like restricted because we can take care of all of them. So yeah, it was pretty like disappointing then Gojo like one-shotted Hanami, where we were seeing like such a great character development of Yuji. But yeah, this episode was like a banger, and I can say easily it is a better episode than episode 19 of Demon Slayer. So yeah, if you have been watching this video for so long, so like the video and subscribe to the channel, and I will like upload next video will be like Attack on Titans episode 11. So yeah, stay tuned for that, and see you guys in the next one.